Even as vaccinations for younger children are expected to ramp up soon, COVID-19 vaccination rates for adults have slowed across much of the country. Nationally, about 70% of Americans 18 years and older are fully vaccinated. But many cities and states aren't giving up on pushing that number higher. Amna Nawaz reports on one effort in Washington, D.C. that brings vaccines straight to residents' homes.
Every morning in this Washington, D.C. warehouse begins like this. Nurses prepping, packing up, and rolling out portable sub-zero freezers full of COVID-19 vaccines.
Today, we're doing 20 vaccinations.
Patrick Ashley helps lead the district's health emergency response. That includes this program that takes the vaccine straight to people's homes.
We want to take out any excuse that they might have of why they wouldn't get vaccinated. So we've heard from some people that it's childcare. So we've taken that away. We've heard that, you know, it's hard to find. You pick up a phone, we'll schedule it for you, we'll come to your house.
Hello, hi, how are you? My name is Ade. I'm calling from Department of Health.
Yes.
Yeah, I'm calling regarding your vaccination for today.
On this day, Ade Dalapo Adebite, she goes by Ade, is one of two nurses crisscrossing the district to dole out doses.
So with this homebound, it literally makes people feel safe. I'm in my home. I have a nurse coming to me. I get to be in the comfort of my zone, my home, and they feel safer.
Since launching this spring, D.C.'s at-home vaccine program has administered more than 1,500 shots. It's a fraction of the 1 million shots the city's given out. But officials say it's just one part of the district's plan to boost its vaccination rate, which at around 75% is already higher than the national average.
We're not going to get everybody with this program, but it does provide yet another option for individuals to get vaccinated so that we're not just doing 7 out of 10. We're hoping for 10 out of 10 eventually.
In fact, the majority of residents using the service are getting their first COVID vaccination.
Hello.
But Adebite's first stop today is to administer boosters to 90-year-old Peggy Templeman.
Hello, Mrs. May. How are you this morning?
And her caretaker, Lillian Bazemore. Both were originally vaccinated in the spring.
It's difficult for me to get out and about.
So if they hadn't come to you to give you the shots, how would you have gotten your vaccine?
I would have had to go out, which would have been kind of difficult for me, more difficult than staying in the house.
Bazemore says she works around the clock, making it hard to go get a vaccine during business hours, even though it's crucial for her job.
I work around seniors, and I'm always around seniors. I can't afford for any of them to get sick, so I'm afraid to take something to them. You know, even though I might not feel bad, I wouldn't want to, you know, jeopardize them.
Right there.
Adebite delivers the doses.
And we are done.
Monitors for side effects and answers questions on site. Sometimes she asks some of her own, especially now that demand, she says, has ticked up.
Do you ever ask them why they waited till now to get the shot or why they're getting it now?
So for first doser, when you ask, is like, my job is making me get it.
Most of them because of getting them because of mandates.
Right. Oh, I didn't know I could get it. Oh, I didn't know how serious it was. Oh, there's another variant. And it's like, wow. Yeah, you'll be so. Oh, I didn't. And some people, it's just education.
Health officials tell us among the many reasons people share for why they choose to get vaccinated at home, privacy is something they hear often. In fact, even though most of the shots they administer are first or second doses, none of those patients wanted to talk to us today.
Whatever avenues are available to us to get more shots into arms, we need to take advantage of them.
Dr. James Hildreth of Nashville's Meharry Medical College says every shot counts, and figuring out how to get to people who aren't looking for the vaccine is a challenge for health officials nationwide.
Trust is a huge issue here. So whether it's a city or a state or a federal agency that's trying to get more vaccines, we've got to identify trusted organizations and trusted individuals to be engaging the communities, those who are resistant to vaccines, because that really is what makes the difference when you have someone engaging those who are hesitant, who they trust or respect.
We're going to the last morning appointment.
Back in Washington, D.C., Adebite's day continues. House after house, shot after shot.
Do you think about the role that you're playing in sort of the bigger picture of ending this pandemic every day?
Yeah, initially it wasn't much of like, I just felt like I was working, like it's just me doing my day-to-day work. But knowing what the COVID did to everybody and how long it's taken for us to like get over it, it's really exciting to know that people are actually coming out now. For whatever reason they're coming out to get it, we're just glad that we're able to help.
One patient and one shot at a time. For the PBS NewsHour, I'm Amna Nawaz in Washington, D.C.